What's going on, everybody? Doc and Sloth back again. A little bit more Rocket League action. I'm going to tell you, honestly, I'm not having such a good Rocket League day. So hopefully Sloth's here to carry me a little bit. Hopefully his router calms down. We played a couple warm-up matches, and that was going a little haywire. So just maybe not our day for Rocket League, period. But we enjoy playing this game, so we're going to do that. But Sloth's got a couple things we want to talk about, and that's a beautiful shot to start off. So let's just watch this in silence real quick. And this is going way better than anything has before today. Nice little bump. Nice. Very nice. But Sloth, go ahead.
My favorite move there, the chip and chase. The big thing with Rocket League in the last couple of days is we had the 12 Titans tournament that happened. The YouTube channel League of Rockets hosted that. It was actually on Twitch at the time, but they should be uploading it. And I just stole that from you. But 1v1 tournament, it was, I'm going to say amateur, but I use that in a very respectful way. I just mean that Psyonix was not officially part of it. It was a tournament that was kind of set up by one guy. He wanted to, I think, make a smart business move and try to show Psyonix what he can do, and just loves the game. So he put 500 of his own bucks up for a 1v1 tournament. Said, you know, these are the 12 biggest names in the game right now. I want them to come in and play for it, and I'll put up 500 bucks. And right after he announced, that guy left right after putting that in. After it was announced, another user actually contacted him and put another 500 bucks in. So it was a $1,000 prize pool. The editing and the videography were amazing. We had Johnny Boy and Mega Shogun do the casting for it.
Nice.
And if you're familiar with the pro scene at all, they're both fantastic. They're really good casters. So it was really professionally done, and I won't ruin anything for you, because I think it's definitely worth the watch. I wouldn't want you to not watch it because you know who won or who got eliminated at what time. But worth the watch. Quite a few things happened that were not expected by me, at least. And then, I don't know, I was just really surprised at a couple different points at how this person performed. Whether that be good or bad, I'll leave that out. But it was really, really interesting. If you do watch it, I'd love to talk about it, because it was awesome. Worth your time. Please do check it out. Anything that supports the esports kind of section of the community, especially for this game, I'm all about. It's only going to make the game bigger. It's only going to make the game more popular. And that's actually the only thing that's been keeping me buying crates, is just knowing that a portion of the money used to buy keys is going up for RLCS and things like that. So that's actually been keeping me interested in spending money on the game.
Yeah, kind of similar to the notion of what Halo did with their packs, I guess, where a portion of that goes to their competitive scene. I think that's a great idea. And again, you told me about this, I think, 1 or 2 days ago, right when you had watched it, and something I wasn't aware that was even happening. So it's kind of cool. Hopefully those of you watching that are Rocket League fans, go over and check that out. Again, should be up on YouTube. If it is, we'll throw a link down below. Obviously just want to give some hype to them, and like you said, show a good product when people are putting it up, and kind of supporting the community, which is really neat.
Yeah, I was really happy with it. Just, if nothing else, just the editing and the shots that you would kind of pan into bringing people into the stadium and the narration and stuff. Really cool. So at the very least, we will link you to the YouTube channel for League of Rockets if he hasn't posted it yet, because the tournament was actually hosted on Twitch.
Okay.
So it was pre-recorded, and then it was on Twitch, put on Twitch after that.
Gotcha.
But we'll at least do that. The other thing that I was kind of doing today, I had a little bit of free time where I was kind of sit around twiddling my thumbs. User on Reddit put up a post, Drew Breezy, with really good post. He kind of gave some of his credentials for the work he's put forward to checking out some of the cars. Since the game has come out, since I've gotten the game, all we've heard is turn radiuses are different for cars and hitboxes are different for cars. Other than that, I've never met anybody that knew what those differences meant and what those differences actually were. We just kind of knew this one feels better. I'm not sure why all the pros use Octane. You know, jack of all trades, maybe. And it was a little frustrating to not know that. So Drew Breezy actually did a really good job of explaining the Breakout S is really long and kind of narrow, so it can be difficult to direct your shots with it. Nice. And the Octane is that jack of all trades, but it has issues here, here, and here. Mm-hmm. It was actually a really good read, and it really explained why almost 100% of the pros are either using the Octane or the Batmobile or sometimes even the Dominus. So worth a read, especially if you're getting into it. I have 500 plus hours in this game, and I found it to be a good read. So something I definitely wanted to point out. Again, it's somebody's putting out something that they put a lot of work into, and it's good stuff. Definitely worth checking out, especially for this game.
Yeah, and
by the time...
Sorry, I was going to say, that was something that we talked about, and I actually asked you, I think just prior to this, we were playing some warm-up games, because you kind of mentioned it, and, you know, I'm a personal fan. Again, as Sloth said, you will see us using the Breakout. One, because I think it looks awesome. I think it's probably one of the best-looking cars, but two... I like it because I think the turn radius compared to what I had been using before feels better to me, and I feel like I can make a little bit more quicker adjustments, and I think I need to because I'm kind of new, obviously, than with some of the other cars, which has obviously helped me.
I don't know. I actually used the Dom for a match or two because I was interested with the notion that the guy brought up of, since it's a kind of narrow front to the car, mm-hmm. that it can be hard to aim your shots because you don't have as big of a paddle to work with. So I kind of worked with the Dominus. I've gotten so used to the Breakout. I do love the length on it. Dodging forward to block shots and stuff is great because I have a really large surface area to work with, but worth checking out, especially if you're relatively new to the game. I kind of mentioned that, but you get used to using a certain car, and it can be hard to break out of that, I think. The pros are going to be the pros. They're always going to be good no matter what car they use, but I think for you and me and all the normal people out there, you're going to get used to one car and you're going to use it like crazy. And if you switch, you're going to struggle. So if you're going to make a switch, it's usually good to do it relatively early.
Which is something I had done. I wasn't using the Breakout until you kind of, you know, had kind of mentioned it and talked about it. And, you know, I'd messed around with a little bit of other stuff too, and just found that I liked this. And we were just talking about crates as well, and I just picked up a crate 4. So I'm pretty excited for that. With that showing on screen, I just do want to mention we are going to try to do a crate opening here. I've just been playing as much as I can, and I know Sloth has been too. And we're going to just try to get a crate opening going for you. Probably do around 20 or so crates, all different mix. I kind of want to get a little bit more crate 3s and 4s, because for those of you that are watching have probably been around the game at least a little bit, know all about what crate 1s and 2s kind of have in them. So hopefully we can get that going. But look out for that in the future. We definitely do want to do that. And plus, I want to open some stuff. I know I got a Breakout S body style, thanks to my main man here, Sloth. But besides that, I really don't have many other items, and I definitely want to try to grab a few up, so I will be happy to crack some crates.
Yeah, and I actually, our last warm-up game, we were talking, I didn't want to interrupt, which I do a lot. I do apologize, guys. We're using the party chat, so there's a little lag time. So a lot of times when I start talking, I haven't heard Doc say anything yet, and then I sound like a moron. But we were talking a little bit. I actually pulled a crate 4 last game as well.
Nice.
So been decently lucky there. The other thing that I'm really interested in, I really want to see what this player's choice crate will bring.
Right.
As far as all the items, they actually have announced we just started recording. I looked up, they are doing a content update, or an update, I should say, instead of being presumptuous. They're doing an update about by the time this video will be up, probably. So
yeah,
that was just kind of poor timing on our part. I do apologize for that. And I don't really want to speculate about what's in it. I hate to speculate and be wrong, but I am hoping for maybe some new painted uncommons, maybe some fix for some of the issues that we've seen, like with the Octane wobble, the Batmobile wobble with landing. As fun as wobble is to say, not that much fun when you're playing with them, I could understand. Right. So probably a good thing to get that taken care of. I don't anticipate that it will be the player's choice crate, because that voting is actually going through tonight at midnight, Pacific time.
Yeah, so, one thing we talked about, potentially maybe they're just setting up for it, which, you know, sometimes they got to do some different, you know, server side type things and some other content type updates to try to just get ready for it. And we are really looking forward to, you know, them kind of letting us know what we can kind of expect for that player's choice crate. So we will see. Maybe we'll be luckily, happily surprised and a little bit lucky. But you never know.
Yeah, that is probably too true. They're probably have a pretty good idea at this point who's going to, you know, who's voting for what items and what items are actually going to win that. So they may be getting things ready for it. And then just kind of flipping a switch when the time comes. I'm hitting the ball entirely too much. I apologize.
No, you're good.
So that would be cool. I would appreciate that. I do like a lot of the painted lightnings. They're just, if you're in the trading community, that's the prices on them is just insane.
Right.
So having a little bit more in the market will probably only help.
Oh,
playing a little kissy face with that guy over there.
Yeah, I should have broke on this earlier. And that's actually one thing, a topic we can actually talk about now, if you want to, a little bit. We've mentioned it a few times, just the trading community, the trading market, and kind of why the player's crate was going to be so cool. Was just because, again, like you said, it's going to introduce some stuff that's probably a little too rare right now that everybody wants, because it is really cool. So it might make some of the, I guess, the online trading piece of it a little bit cheaper.
Shake up a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm really hoping that is the case, because there's a couple different avenues to go through that you had a much better shot for that.
Yeah.
I got really lucky. I apologize.
That's okay. I was in there with you. I don't know if you saw. I had a really good aerial hit earlier, and I was going to hit that too.
You did.
Guys, I swear I'm getting better, kind of.
You have to quench your pride, so you don't cry, kind of thing. I really am, honestly, though, like, happy with your progression. If I stop jumping in front of you, that is, that will be super helpful. But yeah, you are getting much better on a consistent basis, and it is really cool to see. And I went all around that ball. It was really neat. I, like, totally faked him out.
Oh! This is funny, because this is...
Oh, I played a little defense! My gosh, oh, my God!
It looked like it almost
I bumped
rolled,
that dude
in.
Hard.
And I'm so far. I'm so all screwed up. I thought that was in. Like, there's sometimes where I just give up because I'm like, this is going in. And that was not one of those. That was one of those instances. This is going in. Oh, bing!
Put that in. Yes. Beautiful. The Zombas, which I'm, if I had to bet money on it, I would think that the Zombas and the Lightnings are going to be the two exotics. They're the most expensive wheels out there. For good reason. They're cool. They're animated. They're really neat, and just anything painted is trade bait for a lot of stuff, just because it's really neat. But it's gotten to a point where the Lightnings are worth, you know, 5-6 black market decals, depending on which decals they are and stuff. And it's just, it's crazy to me. But the thing that kind of throws a wrench in, I think, the Xbox trading is you're not allowed to trade keys.
Right.
You can only trade crates and stuff. Whereas in the PC and PlayStation markets, you can trade keys. So it's really easy for the market to say, okay, if I want Crimson Lightnings, they're worth, you know, 50 keys or whatever the actual price is.
Right.
But on Xbox, you can't do that because there's nothing to say. You can put everything in crates, but if you say crate threes are your currency, crate threes are constantly changing. Mm-hmm. So it's like the Federal Reserve changing what a dollar means every day.
Right.
It makes it really frustrating. So hopefully the the lightnings will kind of calm down a little bit. I don't think we're ever going to see a fix to the whole not being able to trade keys thing, because that's a Microsoft terms of use, because they count that as DLC. Mm-hmm. And you're not allowed to trade. I went really country there for a second. You're not allowed to trade paid DLC to other people. So I don't think we're going to see a change to that, unfortunately. But I don't know. You never know. If the money's there, I'm sure Microsoft can change something. But
yeah, I mean,
I'd like to see some changes to
that. That is the tough part too. It does kind of sink that, you know, it's not the same across all platforms. But that's just sometimes what you deal with. Just like I'm a little salty that PlayStation. I think everybody's playing Raven the Redwoods right now, and I'm sitting here waiting for it to come out. But you know, that's just sometimes when you pick when you pick a console to play against, that's just what you kind of do.
There's always the chance we could bring some PC stuff too. We both have pretty decent PCs. For us, I think the issue with what platform to play on has always been what are my friends playing, and that's the only thing that's really important to us. So. You know, we're not really interested in the console debate between consoles or with PC or anything. So we'll see. Maybe we'll be able to bring a little bit of PC action too.
Yeah, for sure. Well, hope you guys enjoy it again. Hopefully bring you some good Rocket League content. If you are just watching this, go ahead and check out, see if that update did drop and is live. If you need to hop on your box and make that update, do that. Well, we'll throw the links to all that stuff we kind of talked about down below. Make sure you check out that tournament. Like Sauce said, sounds really fun. I'm probably going to go watch it right now because I have a lot to still learn. But yeah, so that'll kind of wrap it up for us. We'll be bringing you more of this and look probably around tomorrow, maybe tonight I'll upload kind of my redemption story for my Road to Rising Star game. I dropped a few divisions today and maybe one, what do you call it? Not divisions. What's the other thing?
Tier?
Yeah. I think I dropped a tier. That kind of just shows you how salty I am at this. But hopefully you guys enjoyed. Check out our other videos. Check out our other content. We are going to be bringing you some more stuff as well. Trying to kind of feel out what you guys like watching. Gears of War 4 seemed to do okay. But let us know down below if there's anything else you guys want to see. I've been Doc. That's been Sloth. Hope you guys enjoyed. Check us out next time.